As Brighton and Hove City Council's budget discussion took place at Hove County Cricket Ground, outside people gathered to voice their concerns about cuts to services.
No ifs, no buts, no public sector cuts! No ifs, no buts, no public sector cuts!
Then protests started inside. After each party's chair made a statement, councillors debated the budget proposals.
Yeah, they say keep your friends close and your enemies closer, but I think our Labour and Tory colleagues have taken this too far.
I cannot believe that it is the Conservatives who are always protesting loudly that tenants' money cannot be misused, yet here you are proposing to take £145,000 from the housing revenue account, which is made up of tenants' rents. What I would particularly like to talk about is Amendment 2, where we want to put money back into respite care and short breaks. Without this preventative service, the costs to both the council and the NHS could be far higher in the longer term.
If they had supported us in previous years rather than trying to score political points, our financial situation would be significantly better now and fewer cuts would be needed. The cuts budget here before us is atrocious. It will have a devastating impact on vulnerable people and contains utterly regressive measures which will drive up poverty.
Following a food break, cases for and against proposals continued, and more than 4 hours after discussions, councillors voted. This means that from April, council tax will rise by almost 3.99%, the most the government allows without a referendum. So this means for a Band D property, the council tax bill will rise by £53.35 a year. The Conservative Party's amendments were also backed, which means there will be investment in grass verge cutting services to improve the look of the city, a reverse in proposals to cut mental health funding, and restored funding to the public toilets budget. All of this is said to be paid for by savings in senior management costs and removing 10 full-time trade union officials employed by the council. So after numerous negotiations between all three parties, a decision was made and the revised budget was passed just before 11 p.m. This is Ceirney Eddy for Latest TV News.